And welcome back to Let's Play Torment Tides of Numenera. I'm the RPG Chick, and now through the miracle of video fast-forwarding, I will speed us back to Circus Minor to try to interrupt this execution.
All right.
The ice, it creeps into everything. Our homes, our hearts, our heads, and cracks them each and every one and all. Okay, so how do we do this? How do we get these people? Dirty scum deserves us. Deserves it. The woman continues to listen to the ravings of the condemned man. I must remember every word so I can find insight in them later. What if I told you he was innocent? That would be terrible, wouldn't it? But his words seem so wise. So you'd stand by and let an innocent man die just to gain wisdom? Indigo Tide raised a small amount. She purses her lips. I didn't know. That would make me appear heartless, wouldn't it? To tell you the truth, I still want to hear his words. She spreads her hands. Does it matter? He's going to die no matter what I do, and what he says could be important. As important as an innocent man's life? Help me save him. Wisdom can be gained without harming another. The woman hangs her head. You shame me, friend. I have put my lust for knowledge before a good man's freedom. That is not the path to enlightenment. Perhaps your way is. I will do this. She thinks, this woman, she is truly wise. So you know, I'm just... The guy is guilty, right? Justice! Let me do this while my spirit is strong. Alright, we need to get more people. Horrified man. The man continues to stare at the execution. This practice is an abomination. It should be forbidden. The horror of it... No? Tell me again what's happening here. That's convincing him the wrong way. Okay, I'm not gonna... What about this mercenary? Yeah, what? Okay, what about this spectator? If you ask me, the victim's speaking nonsense. Delusions of a dying mind, nothing more. The lovely words of a dying man. I must remember every one. A hideous sight, and yet I cannot look away. The woman continues to watch both the execution and the crowd. So depressing. If you find it depressing, why are you watching it? I was just walking by. I don't know why I stopped, really. Something in her manner makes it feel like there's more to it than that, however. You stopped because you're a good person, at heart. It moved you. Gold Tide and Red Tide. Wow, what a combination. Both raised a small amount. Maybe it did, but what does that matter? It can't be stopped, at least not by a nobody like me. Persuasion. I've seen you watching the crowd. You outnumber the Levies 4-1. They just need a leader. Damn it. I'm afraid to use too many points. She thinks about it, then shakes her head. I'm not sticking my neck out alone. Maybe if a couple other people go first. Maybe. I'll get back to her. Excited man. The man glances at you, then returns his full attention to the execution. Good to see you again. Back to see the traitor die? Do you truly care if he's a traitor? Or are you just like watching men tortured to death? He snarls at you. How dare you? It's justice that's important to me, and protecting my city. Then I think you'd be interested in making sure the real traitor gets caught. Indigo Tide. Are you saying this man isn't a traitor? That he doesn't deserve to be up there? His eyes narrow. What do you know that I don't? This poor fool took the fall for somebody else. That's a mockery of Sega's pride. We should free him. I'm gonna have to take another shot. Success. The man grinds his teeth, thinking, then finally nods. Aye. Us small fish are always taking the fall, but not this time. Free the prisoner! What are you waiting for? Let's go, let's go! Shh, I'm trying to listen. Okay, we have one person left. Horrified man, we don't have an option. Well, that's Tyvir. Can we have... What if...
Yes.
What if we have Tyvir do it? Can we do that? No. How are you holding up? Never better, he says, his face a friendly mask. Don't you worry, I'm with you to the end. He thinks the end of my path anyway, but she's been useful thus far. So far. How do I use some of Calistage? I guess I can't. I'd love to use some of her intellect. Alright. These things are expensive. I don't want to use them, but I do want to help this guy. And we need to persuade her. A waste. I hope it works. Is it unmoved woman? What does the traveler have to say? He looks like a little kid. Your people are tall, like the Sona and Bayan in my city. Many in the crowd are ready to act. Or, well, two of them. They outnumber the Levies 4-1. All you have to do is lead them. They do? She looks around at the others you convinced and seems to gather courage. You're right. Something must be done. With numbers on our side, we can do it. She steps forward. I'm ready. You mean we don't need persuasion this time? I use that for nothing? Oh, damn it. Let's end this. What are we waiting for? Let's get this started. Do I do this? How do we start this? Levy? I don't know what to do at this point. I'd like to go up on the platform.
I'm going.
What do we do? Start attacking them? How do I start this thing? Let's do this while my spirit's still strong. I don't know how. What if I tell him this? The horror of it will deter others from crime. Utter nonsense. Punishment for bad behavior won't change a man. Reward for good behavior is far more effective. And that's what... If that's what really matters to the authorities, this is nothing more than spectacle. An amusement for the masses. If I had any courage... He thinks, I wish people weren't so complacent, then it wouldn't just be just me. Indigo Tide raised a small amount. Maybe that's what I just need to get him. He's the last one who's not a spectator. all the other, you know, adjective man and woman have joined us. You're right. The practice needs to be stopped. Join me, and let's put an end to it now. Gold and silver tide raised. Oh, persuasion good. He looks at you frightened. End it? Are you saying we should interrupt the execution? You said the punishment should not be allowed. Did you mean it? Can a just man stand by when injustice is the law? All the way, baby. Success. The man seems to shrink in his skin. My friend, I am a coward. I have always been, but you were right. If a man does not stand by his beliefs, what is he? He swallows, then nods. I will do it. The four people you talked into helping Riss start chanting, "Free the prisoner! Free the prisoner! Let him go! Let him go!" Spurred on by their passion, or maybe just bored, the rest of the crowd begins to pick up the chant. Spectators, "Let him go! Let him go!" They advance menacingly on the Levies and the Overseer. This is awesome. The Levies edge back, their normally pleasant expressions turning into uncertain frowns. The Overseer points directly at you. I saw what you did, you rabble-rouser. This is your doing. Well, I'm not risking my life to intervene in the fate of a worthless piece of belly trash. If you want him, take him. Well, that was easy. I mean, as far as just this part. The Overseer signals the Levies. Unmake the prisoner's death and retreat. He isn't worth our blood. At his order, one of the Levies takes out a device like a circular mirror and squeezes its frame. The mirror spins, flashing shards of light across the death and the umbilical viscera it is wrapping around Riss, and all of it disintegrates. Soon Riss stands alone on the platform as reddish dust swirls away from him. Awesome.
Try something new.
What? Cool! Oh, that scream, that was awesome. Yin, the Overseer, says, "There!" He cries to the crowd. Satisfied? With that, he and the Levies turn and march away as the crowd surrounds the platform and cheers. Awesome. Yay! Justice is done. As the Levies march off and the crowd disperses, Riss steadies himself, not quite recovered from his ordeal. Finally, he raises his head and focuses on you. If you're the one that got me out of that nightmare, thank you. But where's that? His eyes settle on Tybeer. There you are, you slippery bastard. Now where's the money? If I went through that hell for nothing, I'll... He thinks, the bastard left me out to dry. I know it. Riss chokes with emotion. 2 days, Tybeer. I spilled my guts up there for 2 whole days. There's hardly anything left of me. Tybeer steps back, spreading his hands. Yes, about the money. You see, Riss, I was hoping to get a reward for turning in the fellow who sold us that brandy without telling us about its secrets, but... But? Riss snarls. There's always a but when it comes to money, isn't there? I should have known. You only say you'd pay me so I wouldn't squeal on you, and you only save my skin to save your own. He smacks his fists together. Now, am I going to have to fight through your friend to get to you? Or are you just going to step out from behind her and take it like a man? Calm down, both of you. Riss, tell her from the beginning. Indigo Tide raised a moderate amount. Wow, that's like the biggest amount I've seen so far. I wonder if we're gonna, and then Blue Tide a tiny amount. I wonder if we're ever going to see something like, you know, Blue Tide raised an enormous amount. Riss spits, then wipes his lips. There isn't much to tell. Captain Silvertongue here talked me into a dirty job, then disappeared like an abacus, and left me holding the bag when it all went sour. Oh, Riss, says Tybeer. Can you blame me for running when I had a chance? You would have done the same. And besides, if I hadn't, we would have both been sentenced to die, with no one to free either of us. He thinks, lucky that. If my tattooed friend hadn't come along, we'd both be executed in any case. Riss stabs a finger in Tybeer's face. You only wanted to free me because you knew you'd be next on the block once the Devourer ate me. How would the Devourer of Wrongs know that Tybeer was involved? The Dendro O'Hur, says Riss, consume our memories with our flesh. They know everything by the time they finish eating us, and Tiber knew I'd have plenty of memories of him, didn't you, you coward? Who are the Dendra or her? Cultists who eat human flesh to gain the wisdom of the dead. He shivers. The city's been using them as post-mortem judges for years. What was the job? Tiber said we were transporting black market booze to Emrah Jolios, but he didn't tell me that he'd hidden state secrets in one of the bottles using some liquid Numenera trick, which turned a slap-on-the-wrist crime into a damn death sentence. Death sentence, Tiber says, with an uneasy grin. You're alive, aren't you? He thinks I'd have told him eventually. Ignorance was supposed to keep him safe. Risk glares at Tiber from under lowered brows. That's as may be, but you certainly seem to know when the Levies were going to come calling. He looks at you. The Council somehow got wind of the deal and came after us. Funny how I was the only one home when they knocked on the door. The Devourer would have found you guilty, Tiber? Is this true? As far as it goes, he would have learned about me if he had eaten Riss, and I did manage to escape the Levies when they showed up looking for us. But I didn't abandon you, lad. He puts his hand to his heart. Riss, I escaped the Levies and saved you from the Devourer of Wrongs because I love you and did not want to see you die. You have to believe me. Because he loves him? He thinks escaping the Levies was just good luck. That much is true. Oh, so everything else was a lie? Do I? Riss says, cracking his knuckles. I'm with Riss on this, Tiber. You should make amends to him. He's the one who has suffered here. Indigo, raise a small amount. Gold tied, tiny amount. That's right, Riss snarls. And you could start by giving me my share of the spoils. Riss, you don't know what you're talking about. I never got paid, I promise you. This isn't over, you self-serving bastard. Riss jabs a finger in Tiber's face. Hide behind your friend if you like, but she won't keep you safe forever. You're dead, Tiber. Do you hear me? Dead. I'm really getting into this dialogue. Well, crap, Tiber. Advancement available.
Yes.
What did I do last time? Did I increase a stat pool? I increased an ability or skill, I believe. Oh, okay, I increased the stat pool, because that's grayed out. Well, sort of grayed out. It's not selectable. Ability or a skill. You can choose between either improving or picking a new skill or improving one of your abilities. You can only do this once per tier. Okay. So, skills here... I can't even see what there is. But we can see... Ability? Select an ability to improve... Onslaught? Skill. Healing. Or do I? Stop screaming, Nychthemeron. So many choices. Cipher use. With only a slim chance of growing an unexpected appendage or other mutation, my god. Endurance. Perception, I like that. Unlocks conversation options and plus 15 bonus per level on difficult task mark with this skill. Visual, oral, and even olfactory acuity allows the character to notice things others would miss. Yeah, I like that. Perception is always great. I love it in D&D. Thanks. Tiber?
Thanks for helping me free Riss, lass. Not that the little ingrate appreciated it.
So, was it like Riss said? You only freed him so you wouldn't be implicated? I'd be a liar if I said that wasn't part of it, he says, looking at his boots. But I really do care for the boy, and I wouldn't wish him harm for all the world. And I could have run. He chews his lip. I could have. He thinks, probably not far, though. Do you think he will make good on his threats? Should we be watching our backs? I wouldn't worry about it, he says, chuckling. Riss doesn't have as many friends as he thinks he does. I was practically the only one. He thinks, unless he makes friends of my enemies, best not to think about it. It won't happen. I'm afraid I'm inclined to believe Riss's side of the story more than yours. Blue Tide. Tiny Mount. Are you? He says, then shrugs. Well, you're certainly entitled to your opinion. Tell me what you want from me again, now that we're done with this quest. At the moment, all I want is a way out of Sega's Cliffs and some friendly company. You seem to fit the bill on both counts. He thinks, a free ride and a strong arm at my side. How you holding up? I'm fine, lass. I just hope you won't regret our friendship when the time comes to part ways. Why would I? He stretches. Okay. Absolutely. No problem. Downstairs. As you wish, dear. Alright. Looks like we've done that. Now, what if we talk to these people over here? Now that we've seen this thing, this portal, the home of whatever, I wonder if there's any more options. Yeah, the House of Empty Time. I like that though, Shuva. That's cute. Yeah, I'm not gonna tell them that. Shuva, it means adult. Underbelly. Cliff's Edge. Do want to check that out. Government Square. Yeah, I want to go to back to Caravanserai. I'm trying to click on the map like that. Dried virulent meat. Yay. I love my meat virulent. Oh, this guy. Now that we've talked to this people in the Order of Truth, I wonder if there's any option here. Beleazar. Engrossed in studying the caged creature out of the corner of his eye, Beleazar doesn't notice you've returned until a few seconds passed. He flinches and glares at you. Yes? What is it now? Min of Tan Liang sent me. He said you needed my help. You? Beleazar recoils, his thin face a caricature of suspicious jealousy. Yes, I could use an ally. What I don't need is someone taking all the credit for my work. What do you expect to get out of this? He thinks, support from the Order. This is a good sign. A very good sign. I do need money. How about knowledge, though? Of course, Blue Tide raises with knowledge. Your response does not allay the scholar's suspicions by the look of it. He studies you, biting his lip. Then he sighs. All right. This is what I know. He glances around the plaza as if looking for spies, then beckons you to him. I have a device, he says in a hoarse whisper, that can probably be heard from meters away. If someone can get close enough to affix it to the creature's cage, it will activate and teleport the Nychthemeron to the Reef of Fallen Worlds. He snickers and rubs his hands together. And then... He thinks, it's an insane plan, yet how else can I make a name for myself? Greatness demands risks. Demands risk. You'll set it free? Goldhide. What? Of course not. His lip curls. Why would I go through all this trouble to help the creature? Biomechanical organisms fascinate me, and Nychthemeron's doubly so. I've never gotten to examine one up close. So, he lowers his voice, I want you to teleport the creature out of its cage, kill it, and bring me their memory organ. I don't want to kill it. How does the teleportation device work? I'm not sure, he admits, mouth twisting. My former colleague found it within the rusted casing of a war machine. I say former because when he activated it, he disappeared. We found his remains spread across the reef, as if he was hurled at the ground with great force. He looks briefly nauseous at the memory. Now, you might be thinking that the Nychthemeron will perish in the same manner, and it might, but I wouldn't count on it. The creature can float. He thinks, poor Caruth. Most of these test subjects didn't fare so well either. Are you sure you don't know how the teleportation device works? Not yet. All I know is that when it's activated, it teleports whatever is attached to it to the Reef of Fallen Worlds. You want me to kill it for its brain? Isn't that murder? More gold tied. Please, Beleazar says. Rolling his eyes so hard you're surprised you can't hear them squeak in their sockets. It's a machine. It's not alive. If it makes you feel better, tell yourself you're deactivating a faulty device that will defend itself with lethal force. This sounds too easy. I just walk up, plant the device in the creature's cage, and activate it? If it were that easy, I would do it. But the creature's captors protect its cage, and, well, they've already caught me once, but they won't be watching for you. He rubs the back of his hand across his mouth. Tell them you wish to see the beast, and plant the device when they're not watching. And if you get caught, don't tell them I sent you. He lowers his voice to a horrified whisper. They said they'd lodge a complaint with the order. He thinks, there's also the part about killing it, but she doesn't need to think about that yet. Ask to see the Nychthemeron and plant the device when they're not looking. Again, if they catch you, I was not involved. I don't want to kill this thing. I set it free, study it, you know, painlessly, but not kill it. I don't want to help you steal this creature. What? Oh, fine, he says. I can handle this myself. Let me know if you change your mind. I should get gold tied for that, too. How do I talk to it at night? Now I can... I can visit it, which I've already done. Or I can turn this guy in. Good, Kanadu says, furrowing his patchy eyebrows. It's clear that he doesn't understand why you're still talking to him. Welcome back. Need to talk or just listen? How do I wait? And turn. if you visit it at night, it's more, like, intelligent. It might even talk to you, I'm not sure. I don't remember that much from the demo. It's like a demo video. All right.
I'm going.
We're going.
Of course.
Okay, we do need some abilities back. So let's stay here for a night. Tranquility bows as you enter. Welcome back, friend. You have been missed. You begin to wonder if the sense of peace that surrounds Tranquility has something to do with the way she speaks. Her voice is low and rich, and she appears to be modulating it in some way. The technique is subtle, but the effect is profound, calming you and making you a little sleepy. So we've just increased our perception, because so now we can see this where we didn't before. So maybe it's not her perfume, or maybe it's both. You're using your tone of voice to calm me. Is that something you learned?
I think I'm ready to try something new.
She raises her eyebrows. Very few people notice that. Well done. I am indeed manipulating my voice. When I opened this place, I wanted to make it the most relaxing hostel in the Ninth World, and I worked to make every aspect of it soothing, even my voice. It turned out I had a talent for it. I'd like a room for the night. Tranquility smiles. Of course. As before, the price is 20 shins per person. Oh, per person! Damn it, per person. I didn't notice that. That'd be 60. That's almost all our money. I'd rather go sleep back at the what do you call it? The cult of the changing god, which will only be a little more than half our money. As your guest, I ask you again, will you use your abilities to put me into a trance? For a moment, Tranquility seems to consider it, but then she shakes her head. No, as I said, I can't be sure of your safety. Why are we doing this? Persuasion. Please, I promise to hold you blameless if anything goes wrong. Aren't you curious to see what will happen? I guess we'd learn about... No. Failure. She shakes her head. I'm afraid it's not possible. This is a place of safety and peace, and I can guarantee neither of those things if we try this. Farewell. Pleasant journeys. And we need to rest somewhere. I have no intelligence, and I have no more stuff left. I need money. Well, let's level him up.
What do you need?
We need you to level up. How do I get to use his stuff? That'd be great. Let's increase his might. Oh, I can do two. Might and speed.
I've learned a thing or two.
Cool. Issue challenge. All enemies in range who fail to resist gain compelled, dazed. They are forced to attack you and receive minus 15% willpower and minus 15% on attacks. Active for 3 rounds. Tybeer shouts a series of sharp tongue remarks on the appearance and parentage of nearby enemies, drawing their full and furious attention. Okay, that's an obvious nod to Mort from Planescape Torment, with his litany of curses, I believe it's called. That's cool. Choose abilities to learn. Skill with defense. You know how to place your feet, how to angle your shield, and how to deflect your enemy's blows. You dance through combat, and none can lay a finger on you. So plus 10% evasion and willpower. Or resourceful. Gain plus 1 training level in cipher use skill, allows you to carry additional ciphers. I'm going to take skill with defense. Cool. Now we just need skill with getting money. Too bad I can't go around pickpocketing people. That would be awesome. I wonder if we could sell some. You know what? Can you tell me anything about Matkina? This thing doesn't answer anymore. So I'm thinking... sell the cube and the fish. I don't want to sell the book. Yeah. I'm thinking let's do that. But that'll be next episode, guys. Thanks so much for watching and endure. Enduring, do stuff. Next we're going to be going to Cliff's Edge after we sell some stuff and sleep. So thanks for watching. See you in the next episode and endure. And enduring, go strong.